also a subsidiary, an investment company or a venture of the company. Venture means joint venture. Any other persons as may be prescribed. Under this clause, as per Rule 3 of the company specification of definition details rules 2014 has defined a director other than independent director or key manager person of the holding company or his relative with reference to the company shall be deemed to be related to the entity. Now let us discuss what is related party transaction. As per Ind AS 24, a related party transaction is transfer of resources, services or obligations between the reporting entity and the related party regardless whether price is charged or not. And let me go through the provisions of section 188 of the Companies Act. As per section 188 of the Companies Act, subsection 1 defines certain transactions which are treated as a related party transactions. Those transactions are sale, purchase or supply of any goods or materials, selling or otherwise disposing of or buying of the property of any kind, leasing of a property of any kind, availing or rendering any services, appointment of agent for the transaction specified in clause A, B and D. Such related parties appointment to any office, place of the profit in the company, it's a subsidiary company or associate company. Underwriting the subscription of securities or derivatives thereof of the company. Next, disclosure requirements. Disclosure requirements as per Ind AS 24 are related to the financial statements, and as per Companies Act these are related to both agenda of the board meeting and explanatory statement to the notice of the general meeting. As per Ind AS 24, the disclosures are classified into two categories. Category 1 requires disclosure of the related party transaction even if there is no transaction with the parties. And category 2 requires a disclosure only when there is a transaction with the related parties. Now let us discuss category 1 in detail. The following disclosure of relationship, if exist, must be made irrespective of fact whether there have been related party transactions by the entity. An entity is required to disclose the name of the parent if different the ultimate controlling party. Ultimate controlling party may be a person. If neither of the entity's parent nor the ultimate controlling party is preparing the consolidated financial statement available for the public use, the name of the next most senior parent that does so shall be disclosed. Category 2 disclosures. Disclosure to compensation to key manager person. An entity is required to disclose total compensation to key manager person and compensation to each of the different categories. Under these categories, post-employment benefits, termination benefits, short-term benefits as defined in Ind AS 19 are required to be disclosed, and share-based payment transactions as defined in Ind AS 102 are required to be disclosed. And disclosure where there is a there have been related party transaction during the year. Where the entity has had related party transaction during the periods covered by the financial statement, it shall disclose the nature of the related party relationship, the information about these related party transactions and outstanding balances including commitments. And as per the Companies Act, as I have discussed earlier, the agenda of the board meeting has to disclose certain factors, and as per the in case of general meeting, the explanatory statement to the notice of the general meeting should disclose. As per section 188 of the Companies Act, a company cannot enter into a related party transaction unless there is an approval of the board of directors or the audit committee as the case may be. And in case of amount exceeding certain amount as defined in section 188, the company has to take approval of the shareholders. First let us discuss in the agenda of the board meeting. The company has to disclose the name of the related party and the nature of the relationship, the nature, duration and particulars of the contract or arrangement, the material terms of the contract or arrangement including the value if any advance paid or received for the contract or arrangement, the manner of determining the pricing and other terms, whether all factors relevant to the contract have been considered, if not the details of the factors to be not considered. And in case of notice of explanatory statement to the annexure to the notice, the company has to disclose name of the related party, name of the director or key manager person who is related, if any, nature of the relationship, nature, material terms, monetary value, and the particulars of the contract or arrangement, any other information relevant or important for the members to take the decisions on the proposed resolution. And list of exemptions available. Exemptions available to the government. The term government is clearly defined in Ind AS 24. As per Ind AS 24, government includes government, government agencies or other local bodies, other similar bodies maintained by the local authority or national or international authorities. A reporting entity also exempt from the disclosure requirements in relation to related party transactions, outstanding balances and commitments with a government that has control or joint control or significant influence over the reporting entity and another entity that is related because the government is having control or joint control or significant influence over the other entity. However, the company shall disclose the name of the government, the nature of the government's relationship with the entity to enable the users of the entity's financial statement to understand the effect of related party transactions, the nature and amount of each individually significant transactions. For other transactions that are not significant individually but are significant when they are aggregated, either qualitative or quantitative indication of their extent. As per provisions of the Companies Act 2013, as per first and second proviso to the subsection 1 of section 188, shall not be applied to a government company in respect of contracts or arrangements that are entered with another government company. A government company other than the listed company in respect of contracts or arrangements other than those referred in clause A in such company obtains the approval of the ministry or the department of the central government which is administratively in charge of the company or as the case may be the state government. The above exemption shall not be applicable to the government company if the company has failed to file the financial statement and annual returns with the registrar within the due dates. Thank you.